Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Blah Blah Live, a very special Blah Blah Live, a Christmas special. I am Rob Grams.
And I am a truck driver.
And and that's a truck driver?
Sorry, my voice is a bit odd today.
Also known as, a.k.a., also known as Mamin Rivera. And we're here with an extra long Christmas special, Christmas edition of Blah Blah Live. Hi, guys.
And it's a special Christmas edition.
It is a special
Christmas. As you can see, if you're watching us on Facebook.
Oh, you should be watching us by now on Facebook.
From Rob's sweater.
Yeah. I have a
jumper.
Yeah.
No?
Well, a jumper, sweater in American English. Mm-hmm. I'm wearing a Christmas sweater. This is a tradition to wear an ugly Christmas sweater.
Yeah, I don't have a Christmas sweater.
You
or
don't?
A jumper. No.
What
I wanted to buy a Christmas dress, which was a Christmas tree dress. From a shop. I'm not going to say the name, but it's agotado. It's sold out.
From a shop you're not going to say the name of?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we don't mention brands.
No. Not if they don't give us free stuff.
Not if they don't give us free stuff.
Nobody.
Irish clothes brands.
No.
No Irish clothes brands that are on Gran Via in Madrid. Yeah. We're not going to talk about them.
No.
I'm not going to talk
are
about
them. Are they Irish?
I believe so.
But in Irish, they have a in Ireland, they have a different name.
What's the name in Ireland?
Pennies.
Pennies?
Yeah.
Strange. I didn't know that.
Huh?
I'm educated. It's weird to have all these things in front of us.
Yeah, it's our Christmas presents.
Yeah, we're trying to make a wall. We're going to build a wall.
Yeah. Rob said, bring something.
We're going to build a wall.
Calla, calla. Okay. Rob said, bring something Christmassy, and I brought my book.
Yeah, I brought a tree.
Because, guys, if you don't buy my book, I'm not going to have a nice Christmas.
Yeah, she needs it to buy presents for her family.
Exactly.
Let's take a quick look at the comments. But seriously, guys, if you are listening to today's Christmas special in your car or on the radio or on the app, then you should immediately go to Facebook, Barra Grupo Vaughan.
Mm-hmm.
And watch us live. You're missing half the show if you
don't
watch us.
Have you seen how beautiful my book is?
It is beautiful.
I'm spamming everyone.
You are spamming everyone. That's a true story.
It's gold and pink and it has a lot of English inside. It's amazing.
It actually looks a little Christmassy.
And do you know how much it is?
How much is it?
It's just 16.95 euro.
It's just 16.95 euros?
Yeah, 16.95.
Yeah.
That's a very cheap present.
It's a very cheap present.
But it's worth it. I mean, it has a lot of content inside it.
You know, we have a word, or we have a way of saying a cheap present without saying the word cheap.
Cheap, yeah. Because I shouldn't say my book is cheap.
Because cheap
it's cheap for what it is, because it's brilliant.
Yeah, but cheap has negative connotations.
Yeah, it does.
At Christmas, when you have something that is inexpensive, cheap, that you've bought for someone, you say it's a stocking filler.
It
would make a great stocking filler.
Can you fit this in a stocking?
Maybe, I don't know. If I wore stockings, probably because I'm quite a big guy. I've been eating a lot this Christmas. Okay, let's take a quick look at the comments. Juan Ramon Galvez Bocanegra, I will always say your full name, sir. I'll see you there, he says. Today, all about Christmas.
Yes.
That's right. Pilar Manzanarro.
Good.
Serrano.
Very good.
Oh, my God. Says, hello.
Hi, Pilar.
I want for Christmas peace and love, says Juan Ramon. So do I.
Mm-hmm.
Sammy Velveteen says, hello, Rob.
Sammy is back. Hi, Sammy.
She says, hello, Rob.
Where have you been?
It's my internet wife. Hi, Sammy, sweetheart. Kisses, Mamin, beautiful woman, she says.
Thank you, Sammy.
So there's love for everyone today. I love your Christmas sweater, says Pilar. Thank you, Pilar. That's very kind of you to say. Zuli says, hello, my level is not so good, but I'll try to participate.
Of course you have to participate.
Thank you very much.
And that thing she wrote is perfect.
Yeah.
My level is not so good, or that good. You can say too, but I'll try to participate.
That's wonderful.
Perfect.
Well done.
Well done, Zuli.
Fully. Mohammed Imam says, hello, sweet people. Hello, sweet Mohammed. Carlos de Miguel says, hello from the Midlands where I am living. Wow. 2 days to fly to Madrid.
Ooh.
Wow, so you're coming back home for Christmas.
Yeah, we have many listeners that are Spaniards who live abroad.
It's true. We do. It's because Vaughan Radio was spreading the love across the ocean.
Yeah. If you're living abroad, I mean, you're going to need English.
You're going to need it.
This is a good way of learning. Or you can also go outside and talk to people.
Yeah.
But no, we're better than that.
Who wants to talk to real human beings? That sucks. So, if you're only listening live, do tune in to the live feed on Facebook. And we're here to entertain you for the next hour.
And we have a whole hour.
A whole hour.
Una hora enterita.
Yeah.
What are we going to do?
Well, usually a half an hour is too short.
Yeah. Okay. This is important.
Okay.
Lo de las horas y las medias horas a mí me tiene loca, Rob.
All right.
So, in English, if you want to say 3 horas y media.
3.5 hours.
Okay. We don't say 3 hours and a half.
No.
That's incorrect.
That's incorrect.
I always make that mistake.
Yeah.
Always. Because in
but
Spanish
not,
it's
not just you.
3 horas y media. No decimos 3 y media horas because that makes no sense at all. So 3 hours and a half?
No.
No.
Three and a half hours.
But, ¿qué pasa cuando es 1 hora y media?
1.5 hours.
And if it's
And what do you mean?
An hour.
An hour and a half.
Ah, I see, no?
Yeah, there you go. That's the rules, man. I didn't invent English.
Yeah,
I just
but you are
it.
The only one, the only native English speaker that I have around right now, so...
Don't blame me for my stupid language.
So, en resumen, vamos a ver. 3 horas y media es 3.5 hours.
Exactly.
Y así para todas las horas, o 3 semanas,
exacto,
o 3 días, o lo que sea. Y luego, si es una, es... An hour and a half, or
exactly,
1.5 hours.
Yeah, if you're going to use the number, you know, it's a simple. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. It's a simple rule. Sammy says, I want to win El Gordo. She wants to win the fat man.
The fat man.
What's the fat man? I want to win El Gordo, says Sammy. Why do you want to win a fat man?
No,
is she talking about me? Does she want to win me?
No, you're not fat, Rob.
I don't know. I'm going to eat a lot of turkey this year.
El Gordo is the Spanish Christmas lottery.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. There's an illustration on our Facebook right now that says, no cometas el error de decir, I wish the fat guy touches me.
Yeah, no, that doesn't
ojalá
sound...
Ojalá me toque el gordo. No, no lo traduzca literal, ¿vale?
Yeah, it does not sound good when you say that, guys.
No, you can say, I hope I win the jackpot.
Yeah, you don't say, I want the fat man to touch me.
Jackpot would be the...
Yeah, I want to win the jackpot. Yeah.
El gordo. So yeah. El premio gordo in English is the jackpot.
So, yeah, so that is how you say jackpot, el gordo.
Yeah.
In everything, because
no,
a jackpot...
No. Just for the Christmas lottery.
Just for the Christmas lottery.
Mm. Es como el premio gordo, el premio grande.
Yeah, I mean, I get it, but it's funny to say the fat man.
Yeah.
So yeah, guys, if you're watching live online, please interact with us on Facebook. All the comments that we are reading live on the show are our listeners, our internet family, and my internet wife is back, Sammy Velveteen.
Can you guys see us? Because I think we're frozen over there.
Yeah, no, I've paused it.
Ah, okay. Why?
Because I don't like to see myself. I don't like to see my stupid fat head.
Okay.
In the camera. I don't look as good as you do on the thing.
No, you do.
I have a face for radio.
Well, my face today is not the best looking face you're going to see.
Yeah.
We went partying a little bit last night.
We did. Last night was the Vaughan Christmas party. The official Vaughan party for all the teachers and all the people in the office. It was a very late night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why did they do that on a Thursday?
To torture us.
To torture us.
I mean, really, out of the people who work in the office, I think Mammon and I will be here the latest.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
we'll be
true.
Here till 6 o'clock. Antino.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sammy Velveteen says, yes, I'm back, darling. I'm glad to see you both again.
Glad to have you back again.
Yeah, I mean, it's love. It's love.
It's Christmas.
It's a Christmas miracle.
So we actually have a Christmas question today.
Oh, we do?
The question is, what's in your letter to Santa?
What are you asking Santa for? So what's in your Christmas letter.
Esto es otra cosa que me pone un poco nerviosa.
Yeah, it's not on a letter.
Why is it not on a letter?
Because it's inside the text.
But it's on the page.
Well, it's on the paper, but it's in a letter.
Ugh.
Yeah, come on now. The rules are clear.
Yeah, and you also say in a newspaper.
Yeah.
But on the front page.
On the front page.
It doesn't make any sense.
Because a newspaper is folded, and if it's inside, it's in the newspaper.
Oh, but it's on the front page.
Yeah, but we're not talking about the paper. You can say it's on the paper.
But you say, and what about if it is an online newspaper? Eh? You say on the newspaper, but no, you say in the newspaper.
In the newspaper.
But it's online, so it should be on.
Yeah.
Sorry, I think I'm confusing everyone here about
including me. No, if it's an online publication, it's let me think.
No,
you say on CNN, in CNN. Oh.
You say in
on the website.
On the website, but in a newspaper.
In a newspaper. I read it in an article. Because it's about the text, and if it's within the text.
So every time it is in una página, in Spanish it's just en. So you don't have to worry about it. But every time it is en una página, it's on a page.
On a paper.
Also on social media.
Yeah, on paper.
On paper.
Yeah.
But if it is a letter, porque sí, it's in a letter. And if it is a newspaper, it's in a newspaper.
Yeah, but if we were talking about the physical paper, all right? So this is a letter. Okay, someone has written on this paper, but there are words in the text. Do you know what I mean?
Jesus.
Do you know what I'm saying, guys? It's not so difficult. Come on.
It's not difficult. It's just stupid. It doesn't make any sense.
It does make sense. Come on. Sammy says, what is it, Santa Claus or Papa Noel? I tried to be confused about it. I tend to be confused about it. Sorry. I'm not wearing my glasses. It's Santa Claus.
Santa Claus in English.
Or Father Christmas.
Papá Noel in Spanish.
Greetings from Mexico.
Hi.
From Mitra. I don't know how to pronounce Mitra's name. M-T-R-A.
Oof, that's a difficult name. I don't know.
Juan Ramon says, the terrible world of English prepositions. Very, very complicated.
Complicated. I totally agree with you, Juan Ramon. I just hate prepositions.
So it's not so bad. Come on, guys. Come on. And you're at the perfect place to learn.
You know what I say? I always say instead of saying in or on.
The newspaper.
It's in the newspaper.
I read it in a book. Okay. So we are not back until after the new year. Until we are not back until 2019. We don't come back until January.
Yeah. This is our last show from 2018.
This is our last show of 2018.
Mm.
So my question to you, Mamen Rivera, what will be your New Year's resolution this year? ¿Cómo se dice en español? ¿Es it prometa o promesa?
Propósito.
Propósito del año nuevo. New Year's resolution.
Resolutions. To earn more money.
But that doesn't depend on you. How are you
Why do you ask?
Find something easier. lower your expectations.
Lower your resolutions. Okay, my New Year resolution is never to go jogging.
Yeah, to never go jogging?
Yeah.
That's not...
That's something I can promise to myself.
No, but a New Year's resolution should be something that you're going to do in a positive way to improve your life or your health.
Well, you can die if you go jogging.
So no. Your New Year's resolution is to never go jogging.
Never go jogging. Never go to the gym either.
Okay.
And eat... comfort food every now and then. Can I ask you
a question?
Yeah.
How many in 2018? How many times have you been to the gym or gone jogging?
Zero.
So really, you're changing nothing.
Yeah.
Your New Year's resolution is I'm just going to continue.
I'm not changing anything, but that's good. That's a good thing.
So happy are you with your life?
Do you ever go jogging?
No. Come on.
No.
No. The only time I ever run is when I'm about to miss the metro.
Yeah, me too. And even then, if I'm not really...
If I, yeah,
in a hurry or something.
Yeah, there is definitely, if I see that, if I run, I will get, yeah. I mean, I'm not a runner. I'm not an exerciser.
No, me neither.
I don't like it.
Yeah.
Do you guys like exercising?
Yeah, we are a terrible example for everyone.
Yeah.
Don't do anything we say.
Yeah, please let us know what your New Year's resolutions is. Personally, I am going to try and quit smoking. That's my idea.
Oh, that's good.
I'm thinking actually of starting tomorrow.
Wow.
Do you know why?
Why?
Because I have 5 days off of work and I know I'm going to be in a terrible mood. So
you're going to be in a terrible mood because you...
Because I quit smoking. Have you ever quit?
Ah, okay. I thought it was because you weren't coming to the office.
I love my job, my man. I love my job, but not that much.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you're gonna be in a bad mood, so yeah, it's better not to have you around.
So I'll be in a bad mood at home, and then after 5 days, come back to the office. Most of the team is on holiday.
Mm-hmm.
I can still be in kind of a crappy mood.
Yeah.
No one will care.
If you are going to be answering the comments on Facebook, guys, if you see that there is a little bit of audio in the comments, it's Rob quitting smoking.
Yeah.
It's a good thing.
Yeah, forgive me if the comments on Facebook are a little rude. I'd like information about... Why don't you look on the... Just look on the website. Don't be so lazy. So, yeah, that's my New Year's resolution. I'm going to quit smoking.
Yeah, I have to think of one.
Because I smoke a lot. So do you.
No, I don't.
No, you don't. But you do when you're with me because I smoke a lot.
Passive smoking.
Yeah. I'm a terrible influence, guys. So, as always, Sammy is burning up the comments.
Ooh.
Burning up, it means like she's leaving so many comments, there's not enough left for other people.
She says, we never make our new resolutions.
We never make our new resolutions? Do you mean we never achieve?
Yeah, I think she means that. Achieve.
Yeah.
Así es como dices, cumplir un propósito.
Yeah. Oh, we never... Yeah, it's difficult on that because a New Year's resolution can be anything from... It doesn't have to be a challenge. It can be something different, like you, for example. Nothing. My best New Year's resolution is I'm going to do nothing. But yeah, it's true. So it's difficult. Yeah, I would say achieve. We're never going to achieve what we set out to do for the new year. But I don't know. Maybe. I think I can do it. I have a vaporizador, or vaporizer, as you say.
Vaper. In Spanish, it's vaper.
Vaper.
Yeah. And the verb is vapear.
Vapear.
Yeah.
You don't say vaporizador. That's what the guy in the shop said.
Oh.
He was Italian.
Then he might be right. I say vapor and vapear.
So yeah, I have a vaporizer and I'm going to start using it tomorrow morning. Yeah. Hopefully. Hopefully I'm not going to kill my dogs.
Don't kill your dogs.
The last time I gave up smoking, I was like...
No.
I was in a horrible mood for at least 5 days. Like terrible. Ugh. Yeah, I don't want to think about it. You see, when I think about quitting smoking, it stresses me out. I just get so stressed, I need to smoke a cigarette.
That's not good. That's not the way to go.
It's not the way to go.
No.
Rafa says, could it be to reach our resolutions, maybe? Well, you reach an objective.
Reach.
Like, you could say, I want to be a non-smoker. I would like to reach that objective.
Yeah.
But a promise, you kind of...
If it is a resolution, it should be solve, no?
Yeah, I mean, it's not exactly a problem. You don't solve a smoking issue. Yeah, maybe we'll search for this over the advertisement break.
Yeah.
Because, guys, normally, when we have an advertisement break...
Oh, we're going to have an advertisement break, like real radio show.
Like a real radio show.
Cool.
We'll be back after the break.
Not yet, no?
I think he said chase. What was this? Hang on. Yes, I am sporty. Hiking, running, swimming, high intensity impacts training, I think is.
What?
H-I-I-I-T.
What's that? I don't even know what that is.
High intensity training. It's like a workout regime. This is Carlos de Miguel. He's saying what his New Year's resolutions are. And cycling.
Wow.
Yeah, wow.
Now I feel really bad that I don't do anything.
Carlos, you're a better man than me.
No, we will never be.
Yeah, I am so lazy I don't even watch sport on TV.
Me neither.
No, it's too much like exercise. So So, yeah, like, we will be taking a break. But, guys, I don't want you to go anywhere. I want you to stick around. Because after the break, we'll be back. But before we go on a break, I have a little challenge for both you, the listeners.
Oh, wait.
And for Mamin Rivera. Well, Mamin, you're going to know what it is. But you, what you have to do is to describe what is inside Santa Claus's bag. Well, we say sack. We say Santa's sack.
Yeah.
Okay, it's the sack where Santa has all his toys. Right? So you have to reach inside Santa's sack.
Okay.
Very
before
delicately.
The break.
Before the break.
We have time, no?
And then through the break, you guys will try and guess what Mamin is describing. Because there is something in Santa Claus, Father Christmas's bag. Okay, do you want to start?
Okay. I'm a little bit scared now, but...
So you can only describe...
I know what this is or are.
Okay, so start. What materials is it made of, this object?
It's made of plastic, I guess. Mm-hmm.
Plastic? Anything else?
And glass.
Plastic and glass.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything about the shape that could give our friends a clue?
It has a round shape in some part.
So some parts are
some
round?
Some part of it is round and some other are not. I'm not really good at describing
it. Are there any moving pieces?
Yes, there are two moving pieces.
Okay. Is the object something you would use, something you would wear, something... How would this object be used?
You can wear it or wear them.
Oh, them, plural.
That's
a good clue, guys.
Or you can use them too.
Yes, true. This is an object you both use and wear.
But you don't normally have a choice. I mean, if you have to use these...
You have to.
Well, yeah. you have another choice.
Well, it's not to.
Which is not to.
Okay, do you know what it is, guys? Do you know what this item is? Is there anything else you can tell us about this?
I think they're yours.
They are mine. They were, okay, I'll give you a clue as well, guys. I showed you these things for the first time on last week's show.
Mm-hmm, last Friday.
Yeah, and I wish I hadn't because I looked like an idiot. anything else?
No. I think that's all.
Okay, so can you... Okay, let's see. Because I don't think they're going to get it. Okay, are there any moving parts?
Yes, I told you before. There are two moving parts.
Two moving parts. And
they can be opened.
They can be opened.
And if I open them, this is the noise they make. I don't know if you can hear it. If I close them.
If you close them.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you, any of you guys, Sammy Velveteen says, I have no idea, darling.
Mm.
Carlos says, my resolutions progressing in my career and social life. Carlos, perfect New Year's resolution, sir. I'm very proud.
That's a good one.
Yeah. So, we have...
Made of plastic and glass.
Made of plastic and glass. Something
you can
both
wear them.
Use and wear.
You don't have a choice if you have to.
If you have to use or wear them, you have to.
You have to.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it can be dangerous for you.
There are two moving parts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And they are Rob's.
And they are mine. Okay, we have a few answers.
Ooh.
Pilar says socks.
You have to wear socks.
You have to wear them. If you have to wear them, you have to wear them. I poco más. Okay, so there are all your clues, guys. Okay? So we're not going to... We need you to write in the chat, just like Pilar, just like Lau. Write in the chat. Made of plastic and glass. There's a big clue there. We refer to them in the plural. There's another clue.
Yeah.
There are two moving parts. You used to open them.
You can open them.
Yeah, yeah. I'm giving you so many clues. And you know what you win, guys? Do you know what you win if you guess this correct? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Our respect.
The pleasure of being the winner.
The pleasure of being the winner.
That's important.
Kyle Miller is in the chat.
Hombre,
hello, Kyle. I have no idea what's in the bag, but Merry Christmas, guys.
Merry Christmas, Kyle Miller.
Merry Christmas, Kyle Miller. Guys, we'll be going to... Well, Tino hasn't played our outro music. I don't know. The clock here is saying it's break time.
Do we have a break time?
Ah, no, we've still got a minute.
We still have a minute.
This is our Christmas special.
In your letter to Santa. I was going to say on again.
I haven't asked Santa for anything. You know why?
Why?
Because I've been a bad boy this year. And Santa will only bring me coal. That's a tradition, you know that? If you've been a bad boy, Santa Claus brings you coal. What about the three kings? What happens when you've been bad? What do the three kings bring
coal
you?
Coal too.
Coal too?
Yeah.
How unoriginal.
Yeah, I know.
Lau says, a bit of nothing? I love it. Lau's a big fan of the prize, okay, for this quiz. So what is in Santa's sack? We'll reveal the answer after the break.
Listening to Vaughn Radio.
Ho, 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 ho. Merry Christmas.
¿Por qué no te regalas un nivelazo de inglés con nuestros intensivos de Navidad? Intensivos en la semana que tú elijas de clases del método Vaughan. Regálate un nivelazo. Si contratas 2 semanas de formación, te regalamos 5 sesiones de clases telefónicas. O si contratas 3, 7 sesiones. Llámanos. Infórmate 91-133-5833 o escríbenos a cursos@grupovaughan.com. 91-133-5833.
El origen de algunas palabras del inglés es muy, pero que muy interesante. ¿Sabes cuál es el origen de la palabra
robot?
¿De qué lengua viene? Te lo digo en 2 minutos.
¡Ey, te pilla el toro con los regalos de Navidad!
Estas Navidades, no te compliques. Regala inglés, regala Vaughan.
Tenemos libros temáticos de autoestudio, tanto para adultos como para niños.
Para adultos, libros para aprender inglés e historia, para aprender inglés futbolero, para viajar, para cocinar en inglés.
Y para niños, inglés con canciones, inglés para bebés, diccionarios infantiles y mucho más.
Estas Navidades, regala inglés, regala Vaughan. Consulta nuestros libros para adultos y niños en vaughantienda.com. Ahora con gastos de envío gratis. Vaughantienda.com.
Y este mes, si compras cualquier producto de nuestra tienda, llévate los 8 libros claves del inglés por tan solo 5 euros más.
Mira fijamente este péndulo. Fijamente. Muy bien. Izquierda, derecha. Izquierda, derecha. Cuando cuente 3, caerás sumido en un profundo sueño. 1, 2, 3. Duerme. Al despertar, cuando cuente 3, hablarás inglés como un nativo. 1, 2, 3. Wake up. Uy, creo que la he liado.
Que no te cuenten historias. Ven, aprovecha estas Navidades y regálate un buen nivel de inglés. Infórmate en el 91-133-5833 o en grupoaugan.com. 91-133-5833.
Curso intensivo para el First Exam, el programa de Vaughan para superar el examen oficial de Cambridge y obtener el First Certificate, B2. Para más información, grupovaughan.com.
¿Cuál es el origen de la palabra
robot?
¿De qué lengua viene? Pues viene del checo robota o algo así, que significa
forced labor.
Trabajos forzados. Eso suena a robots esclavos, qué buen rollo, ¿verdad?
El vino recibe su crianza enriqueciéndose y perfeccionándose con el aporte del roble y de los años, como nuestros profesores. Los aromas sosegados del lugar, donde permite desconectar y concentrarse de una cata de 5 días muy intensos, donde disfrutará de los mejores caldos lingüísticos, concentrando un año de clases en las mejores barricas exclusivas, pero al alcance de todos. La mejor elaboración, análisis y cata de uno de los programas con más solera. Programa residencial de 5 días, donde su paladar disfrutará de la intensidad del idioma. 91-133-5833. Con los mejores profesores en las mejores estancias. 91-133-5833.
I'm 100% Spanish. I began learning English when I was about 10. and I just fell in love with it, with language. I can't remember a time when I didn't speak English, and that's what I like about it so much.
Be like Elena. Be like them.
Descubre más en grupobaugan.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Blah Blah Live, the Christmas special. Oh my God.
Yay, hungover special.
Yeah, well, we are really hungover today, guys. Hungover.
That's interesting. If you say the noun is hangover,
yes,
but the adjective
hungover.
Estar resacoso,
yeah.
With an ew.
Yeah, hungover.
Hungover.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you say?
Hungover.
And the other one?
Hangover.
Ah. That's interesting.
It is interesting. Should we reveal what is in Santa's bag?
Yes.
Ooh. Okay, so let's see.
Are you going to wear them?
Yeah, probably, because it's really hard to read the comments. So, okay, so who guessed it right? Sammy Velveteen guessed it right when and so did Lau. Lau Lauki when they said glasses.
Glasses
made of plastic and glass.
And glass. The glass part was a...
It was a giveaway, yeah. That they're in plural, glasses, because we don't say glass. We say, these are my glasses, in plural. Two moving parts, because they open and close. You wear them, and you have no choice. If your eyesight is bad, you wear them. So congratulations, Lau, and congratulations,
Sammy. What I meant that you have a choice is that you can also wear contact lenses.
Yeah, you could.
Not contact lentils.
Not contact lentils.
Not lentejas. No, lenses. Lentils, lentillas, lenses. Lentils, lentejas, lenses, lentillas.
That's right. Good job.
Esto es un error gracioso de esos que alguna vez he cometido.
So, congratulations, Lau and Sammy. You have both won nothing.
Yay!
Yay!
Well done.
Merry Christmas! That's it. That's what you win. You win our gratitude.
Yeah.
You win our congratulations. Juan Ramon says, better if you give a present if anyone guess it.
Ah, qué morro.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're not Santa.
That would be, yeah. That would be better. Yeah. But it's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen. Sorry. Sorry.
It's just the world we live in. Better if you give a present if anyone gets it. That's not better. It would be better to give a prize, not a present.
Yeah.
When you win something, it's a prize. If someone guesses it.
A ver, ¿cómo dices premio?
Prize.
¿Y precio?
Price. Prize.
Prize.
And price.
Prize, cuando vibra, es premio.
Premio, exacto.
And when price. Eso es precio.
Precio, yeah.
Yeah, two similar words.
Do they sound the same to you, to your ears?
I have to pay close attention so that they don't sound the same. Because in Spanish, we don't have that difference.
It's
in some varieties of Spanish, in Catalan, for example, Catalan is not a variety of Spanish, but in some parts of Spain, they have that difference.
It's easier to pronounce, maybe, than to recognize.
Yeah.
I mean, a Z is just a S, just an S ps, with your vocal cords activated.
Yeah. Z.
Same
Z.
Like an F and a V, right? Mm. An F is just the F, and a V is with your vocal cords activated. Valencia. Vampire.
Yeah, we don't have that sound in Spanish.
Oh, well, there you go.
Para nosotros todos son Bs.
Yeah. Valencia.
Valencia.
Very good.
Very good. it's a vowel.
Oh, you will like this, my man.
A ver.
Sammy Velveteen says, I highly recommend her book.
Oh, thank you, Sammy. Have you read it?
Yeah, this is some product placement if you're watching the video right now.
Un poco de jeta, ¿no? Aquí con el libro. Bueno, it's Christmas.
Rafa says, glasses, haha. I'd like to win Mamen's new book.
You know what? I was doing a contest some weeks ago.
Oh, yeah?
Draw Mamen a unicorn.
You were?
And Rafa, you could have participated.
Yeah, because you're not going to win it now, Rafa.
No, But maybe I'll do another one.
Yeah?
At some point.
What would you make people draw?
I don't know. Oops. Christmas is over, guys.
Christmas is cancelled. Everybody go home.
If you just,
if you're just listening on the radio, basically our decoration just fell off the wall.
Oh, that was a sign.
Yeah, that was a sign. Oh my God, we're sorry. Gods of Christmas.
So,
what is in your Christmas letter to Santa Claus?
In my Christmas letter to Santa Claus?
What are you asking Santa Claus for?
Trainers, a couple of trainers.
A pair of trainers.
Yeah, a pair of trainers.
Yeah.
Unas zapatillas deportivas.
All right. Why? Okay.
No, just because they look cool, not because I'm gonna do any sport.
But they're called trainers because you're supposed to train when you're wearing them.
No, you don't have to. You can just walk.
The complexity that is Mamen Rivera. She's a woman of mystery.
And that's all.
Yeah. How do you say trainers in American English, Mamen Rivera? Sneakers.
Sneakers.
Yeah.
Sneakers. Do you say tennis? No.
Tennis shoes, they would also
tennis
say
shoes.
in the United States.
Yeah.
We'd say trainers or... Well, no, I think pretty much exclusively we say trainers.
Yeah. And it's a pair of trainers, not a couple.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. You have some Christmas vocabulary.
Yeah,
people.
I do. Well, you know, Raquel and I went to Seoul the other day.
An amazing video, guys.
Raquel
check
is
it out.
Our camera and video girl. She edits most of the videos that we
yes.
post on social media and all that. So we went to Seoul just to check what the level of English around Spanish people.
It was a very funny video. Did you have fun?
I had a lot of fun. It was the first time I was doing that. I was interviewing people on the street with a microphone, and it's really cool.
Because you made me do it all the rest of the time.
But it's really cool. I want to do it now forever.
Well, you will. Are you going to give people a little clue about what you want to do next?
Can we?
You can. It's your show.
Nah.
No, you're going to leave it as a surprise?
No. It's going to be a surprise.
Oh, well, there you go,
so,
guys.
My plan is to go to different places around...
Madrid?
Madrid.
Because there's no budget
or
to send anywhere else.
If we can go, I don't know, to New York or...
Yeah, that's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
Or Japan, no?
No.
No? Vale, pues nada, Madrid. And ask people in the street. In the street or on the street?
On the street.
Ask people on the street.
Otherwise, they would
I hate prepositions.
Otherwise, they would be inside the street.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Because they're standing on the
street.
Yeah.
On the street. Ask people on the street about things in English.
Yeah.
It's fun.
It
is fun.
But
it was really hard to find people that would stop and talk to me in English.
I have to say, I was impressed by the level of the English.
Yeah. Some of them were really, really good.
And some of them were bad.
And a couple of them were improvable.
Because you edited those people out, I think.
No, some of them are there.
Ah, really?
Yeah.
But you didn't let them speak in English in the video. So if you are
doing all the speaking. La, 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 la.
So if you're in the video and you don't say anything in English, it's because Mamen thinks you have a bad level.
No, Raquel thinks, because she was the one who edited it.
Poor Raquel's not here to defend herself. So let's do some Christmas vocabulary.
What I was asking them about was Christmas vocabulary.
Okay.
Por ejemplo, árbol de Navidad es...
Christmas tree.
Bien. Y muérdago.
You know, muérdago.
You don't know what that
is
in
no
Spanish.
I have no idea. What's a muérdago?
Is that a thing you kiss when you're under it?
Mistletoe.
Mistletoe.
I need to buy some mistletoe, guys.
No, sí, suena la flauta.
I need to buy a whole hell of a lot.
bola de Navidad, la que pones en el árbol.
I would just say a Christmas tree decoration. Is a bauble.
Bauble.
A bauble.
I really like the sound of that word.
Bauble.
Bauble. Mola mucho.
Yeah, it's cool.
Estrella de Navidad.
Star.
Star or Christmas star.
Yeah.
That one is easy. Campanas.
Bells.
Bells. Y corona de Navidad. I didn't know this one.
Is it a wreath?
Wreath.
Yeah.
But we spell it W-R-E-A-T-H.
Yeah, wreath.
Gruath. Pero se dice wreath.
A wreath. Wreath.
Yeah. La W muda.
It's the thing you hang on the door of your house.
Ah, y calcetín de Navidad, que lo hemos dicho antes.
Yeah, a stocking.
It's a stocking.
A stocking. And what do you say if you have a...
It's not a sock. It's not a Christmas sock. It's a Christmas stocking.
Yeah. And if you have two?
A pair of Christmas stockings.
Ding, 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 ding. And if you have an inexpensive gift?
It's a stocking...
A stocking filler.
Stocking filler.
Very good.
Rellena calcetines. Stocking filler. Yeah. That's the way I learn new words in English. I translate them literally into Spanish.
Ah, really?
Rellena calcetines. Ya no se me olvida.
Okay.
I have more. Galleta de jengibre.
Gingerbread biscuit.
Yeah, gingerbread biscuits. They're usually made in the shape of little men.
Yes.
Gingerbread biscuit.
We can also say gingerbread man.
Gingerbread man.
Yeah, yeah.
If it is a man.
If it is a man. But I don't want to impose a gender on. I mean, this is... We are living in 2018. I don't want to impose a gender on my biscuit.
Gingerbread person.
A gingerbread person.
That's it. Es una persona de jengibre.
Yeah, you can be a man or a woman. We don't care.
Yeah, exactly. Bastón de caramelo.
I'm trying not to look at the answer. It is... Candy cane.
Candy cane.
A candy cane.
You can't say sweet cane, no?
No, no, no.
It's not, it's just the American word.
Yeah, candy cane. Even in England, we call it a candy cane.
Candy cane. Espumillón.
Tinsel.
Tinsel.
Okay.
Y postales de Navidad.
Christmas cards.
Importante decirlo de cards, porque en español son Christmas.
What?
Me han mandado un Christmas.
Really?
Y eso quiere decir Christmas card.
What that really means is I've sent someone Christmas.
Yeah.
That's a lot to send someone.
Yeah, but in Spanish, that's what we say.
Que manda un Christmas.
And now I want to talk to you about something that I'm interested in.
Okay.
Do you have nativity scenes in England? Nativity scene es el Belén.
Well, they're getting less and less popular because of our wonderful multicultural society.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I'm not a religious person, so I don't care if I see a baby in a thing with donkeys. I mean, that doesn't say...
That's what I want to ask you about. What's in an English nativity scene?
It's like three people looking miserable all drinking tea. That's how we do Christmas in England. No, it's the same as a Spanish nativity scene. So we have the three wise men.
The three wise men es como decimos los Reyes Magos. Yeah, yeah.
Then there is like typically farm animals like a donkey, a cow, sheep.
There's no specific, because in Spanish we have two animals that has to be present in every single nativity scene.
A donkey and a cow, right?
La mula y el buey, que sería donkey, sería mula, y ox.
Ox.
Sería buey.
Maybe it's the same in England. I have to admit, I don't care. No, I don't know. I don't know. My family is very religious. I was raised Roman Catholic, so there were Belens in my house.
Mm-hmm.
But when I was young and I still lived there, I was way more focused on the gifts under the tree than the Belén.
Yeah, so we don't put gifts under the nativity scene.
No.
No.
But if you did...
Christmas tree is much more interesting there.
Yeah. If there were presents in there, I would pay a lot more attention. So what did I say? So farm animals, three wise men.
Do you know, when I was a kid, I used to create my own nativity scene with Barbie.
But who would be baby Jesus?
I had a baby Barbie.
A baby Barbie?
Yeah. Shelley was her name.
So Barbie is a mother?
Of course. She's everything.
Yeah. Parece. We spoke about this last week. You had a vet Barbie, right? A veterinarian?
Yeah. And a dentist.
Do you have the Barbie?
It was so much fun because the dentist one had voice. So you would press a button on her back and she was like, okay. No tienes caries, pero se quedaba sin pilas y decía, rur, 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 rur. And it was really scary.
Who in the toy industry thought, we need to create a Barbie. We need to create a Barbie that's fun, that people, that boys and girls will love. Let's brainstorm, lluvia de ideas. Let's brainstorm some ideas. One guy around the table says, dentist. And everyone goes, yeah, dentist, Barbie.
That sounds like our Monday meeting.
Let's go home. Good job. Dentist Barbie.
Yeah. They have teeth. I mean,
really?
They have a white
stripe.
And
painted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They need a dentist to paint that stripe.
They just need
to keep it white.
They need a painter. They need Tippex. Honestly, they
Tippex.
You see, I think we should say correction fluid is the correct way to say it.
Yeah, right? It's not the brand. Tippex is the brand.
It's the brand, no? Yeah. Like Sellotape.
Yeah.
Is a brand.
Mm-hmm.
Cello. We say Sellotape, but Sellotape is a brand, really. It's adhesive tape. Or sticky tape.
Yeah.
Colloquially. To vacuum. Commonly in England, you'll hear people say, we're going to Hoover.
Yeah.
But Hoover is a brand.
And it's a verb in that case.
Yeah.
You Hoover.
We're going to Hoover the floor.
Well, the floor. That's the only thing you can Hoover.
Yeah. Yeah. Really.
Or the sofa.
Not if you mean I Hoover everything because I don't
I'm going to Hoover the windows.
Not the windows, but the sofa and curtains.
Yeah.
And suck up the dust. My grandma is awesome at cleaning. And she always told me, Rob, don't dust with a duster. Don't clean the dust.
A duster is a plumero?
Yeah, exactly. She says, don't clean with a duster the shelves. put the attachment on your vacuum cleaner and hoover the dust. That way the dust doesn't go back in the air and land back on the surfaces.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Do you have a Hoover?
Yes, I do.
I don't.
No?
Yeah, that can be on my my Christmas letter to Santa.
But if your boyfriend gave you a vacuum cleaner...
If it is one of those that go alone, like, do you know those ones?
Yeah,
that,
a Roomba.
A Roomba, or the Chinese version of a Roomba.
I know you well enough to know if your boyfriend got you a vacuum cleaner, yeah. You would be so offended.
A little bit. But if it's one of those, I'll be happy. It's a good present.
It's a robot.
Yeah, it's a robot. It does everything for you.
Yeah, but it doesn't do the dishes or anything like that.
Yeah.
Just the floor.
That would be cool. That would be the real future.
Sammy asks, how would you say... what? Arre borriquito.
Yeah, arre borriquito.
I have no idea.
So that's a Christmas carol in Spanish. And it means arre is what you would say. Borriquito is like donkey.
Okay.
Como...
Like a burrito.
Yeah.
Like a little donkey.
Like a little donkey, but you don't eat borriquitos.
Well, I just instantly got hungry by saying little donkey.
So, arre is what you say to the donkey. So that it...
Hurry, donkey.
Hurry.
Hurry. Hurry along. Yeah, to move quickly.
Yeah.
Hurry up.
Yeah.
Donkey.
Hurry up, donkey.
What a weird language, Spanish.
Talking about translating...
Oh, God.
Christmas carols.
Oh, that's the end of the show, guys. It's been a lot of fun.
I think this happened a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, you're going to make me...
We began translating my favorite Christmas carol or Christmas song in the world, que es Los Peces en el Río.
Los Peces en el Río.
Because it makes absolutely no sense. The lyrics are really stupid and fun.
Okay, please, guys, in chat on Facebook Live, help me.
Help Rob.
Help me translate
this. We're going to translate Los Peces en el Río.
Okay, let's do this.
Okay, peinando, ¿eh? A different thing. ¿Cómo pensaste la otra vez? La Virgen se está peinando entre cortina y cortina.
The Virgin is brushing her hair
mm-hmm.
between curtains.
Good.
Okay.
Between curtain and curtain.
Oh, between curtain and curtain.
Los cabellos son de oro. Cabellos, no caballos. Cabellos.
Cabello. The hairs?
Yeah. You don't use hairs in plural.
No, the hair.
The hair. El cabello.
Okay, the
son
hair
de oro.
Is of gold.
Like my book.
Like your book.
El peine de plata fina. Peine.
Yeah, this is the thing. The peine. I was taught this meant something completely different.
Peine con I.
Okay.
It's a Christmas carol, Rob.
It's going to get a bit adult in here, guys.
No.
It's going to get adult up in here. It's a painting. And it's made of silver.
So.
The brush. The comb.
The comb.
The comb.
Comb.
Very good.
Y no decimos comb. Aunque no, hay no, una no. B ahí, es muda, ¿no?
Aunque comb. Hay B, yeah, es muda.
Comb es peine y brush, cepillo.
Yes.
Yo siempre le llamo peine y cepillo a los dos indistintamente, en so español y en inglés.
There's a comb made of silver. I knew. And that's what I was talking about.
And now this is my favorite part. Pero mira cómo beben los peces en el río.
But look how they drink the fish in the river.
Pero mira cómo beben por ver al Dios nacido.
Look how they drink. What are they drinking? Are they just drinking the river water?
Yeah, they're breathing, they're not drinking.
Yeah, that's breathing. That's,
no,
that
but
breathing.
The villancico says they drink.
What are they drinking, though? Cava, right? It's Christmas.
No sé.
Look how they drink, because... what is it? To repeat the line?
Pero mira cómo beben por ver al Dios nacido.
Look how they drink for drink. Look how they drink for seeing baby Jesus getting born. Being born. Sorry, being born. My bad.
Baby Jesus being born. That's important too. In English, you no naces, te nacen.
Yeah,
porque
exactly.
Es en pasiva.
Exactly.
So being born. Beben y beben y vuelven a beber.
They drink and they drink some more.
Los peces en el río por ver al Dios nacer.
These fish have a drinking problem. These fish are Irish. Okay, wait. Tell me again.
Los peces en el río es lo mismo, por ver al Dios nacer.
What's the whole line? The whole line.
Beben y beben y vuelven a beber los peces en el río por ver al Dios nacer.
They drink and they drink and they drink for seeing baby Jesus being born.
La Virgen está.
How could they see him being born? He was born in the Middle East. There is very little water around there.
Ah, pero los peces en el río.
What? They, with binoculars. From very far away.
Yeah.
Oh, were they looking at pictures? Like, was there a home movie?
Rob,
I don't know.
It was a miracle.
Okay, it was a miracle.
So whenever you don't understand anything, you can say, it was a miracle.
It was a miracle.
So the fish were drinking.
They were drinking.
In the river. Not breathing.
Not breathing. Drinking. Cava, we've already.
Cava.
Yeah.
And celebrating because they could see.
They could see. I don't know how, but they could.
Miracle.
Okay? A miracle.
No te lo cuestiones.
Juan Ramon very quickly says, don't touch the backside of a donkey. Is very dangerous. It is very dangerous.
Hablad por experiencia propia, Juan Ramon.
Yeah, yeah. What happened in Juan Ramon's past?
Tell us about that.
There is a story there. I sense it. Okay, carry on. Let's continue.
La Virgen se está lavando. No, la Virgen está lavando y tendiendo en el romero.
Okay, the Virgin... Is washing herself?
No, not herself.
Oh, is washing.
Lo he leído mal. Está lavando.
She's washing and
tendiendo.
Hanging things. Is she doing? She's doing a laundry.
She's doing the laundry.
The Virgin is doing a laundry.
But yeah, that's what the translation would be. The Virgin is doing the laundry.
The Virgin is doing her laundry.
En el romero. No sé qué es el romero. Un árbol.
In the romero. Well, in the romero, no, it's rosemary, right? A rosemary bush. It's the herb that smells very, very nice.
Ah.
I don't know.
So she's doing the laundry by a rosemary
rosemary bush.
Los angelitos cantando y el romero floreciendo.
The angelitos. Are those the
aquí
little...
Aquí ya se vuelven locos.
The angelitos are those little fat baby angels.
Yeah, baby angels.
So we call those... Hang on, wait. We call those... Oh, God, there is a name for those. Cherubim.
Ah, querubines, yeah. In Spanish. Ah.
So the cherubim, los angelitos, what was the thing?
Cantando.
The cherubim were singing.
Y el romero floreciendo.
And the rosemary was flowering.
Yeah.
So I'm doing well today, guys.
She
high five.
Has just had a baby. And she is, you know, brushing her hair.
She's a busy woman.
She's doing the laundry. What is San Jose doing?
Yeah.
Nothing.
He's watching. It's Christmas. He's, you know, he's watching TV.
He's just with the ox and the donkey.
Hang on a second. Juan Ramon says, yes, I am a vet. So he has been kicked by a donkey.
Okay. Now I understand.
Sammy says, this is a before and after in Vaughan. We shall go down in the history, darling. We shall go down in history. We shall go down in history, darling.
We should go down in history. Vale. Bueno, que está haciendo the laundry.
She's doing the laundry and she's washing her hair.
Pero mira cómo beben los peces en el río.
But look how they drink the fish in the river.
Pero mira cómo beben por ver al Dios nacido.
Look how they drink because they've seen baby Jesus being born.
Beben y beben y vuelven a beber.
They drink and they drink and they drink some more.
Los peces en el río por ver al Dios nacer.
The fish in the river for seeing baby Jesus being born. What a ridiculous song.
I love it. You can imagine everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's got very powerful imagery. Yeah.
Importante, in English we say fish for one fish and for many fish.
In everywhere except one place. Do you know where the one place where you will read fish is?
Fish is.
Yeah. In the Bible.
Ah.
Yeah, yeah.
What is it with religion and fish?
I have no idea.
Something going on there.
I don't know. It's something about them being in the river
yeah.
and drinking. I don't know. I haven't read the Bible in a very
Venga,
long
la
time.
Última estrofa.
Really? Because we've got to go, mami.
Ay, bueno, pues nada. Para el año que viene.
For next year. Guys, it's been a wonderful show. This has been the Blah Blah Life Christmas special. Thank you so much for hanging around and keeping us company. We will see you in 2019. I'm Rob Grams.
And I am Mamen Rivera.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Jobs, I wish I had.